Now the next question, so we knew the origin of the undercuts, where they came from. Now we need to know, are they shallow or deep undercuts? If I am going to use this mirror, I'm going to like create a path of a withdrawal and just compare the tissue. Now, if this is prevented and I feel that there's like a shelf and it goes in there, and that means this is a deep undercut. And yes, your question was valid, that yes, this patient has deep undercuts. So if you are going to use your finger, for example, if my finger, suppose this is an undercut, if my finger can feel it, but you slip away and there is no retention in it, that means it's shallow. But in this case, I could put my finger and feel resistance. I could not go downwards, okay? I feel resistance if I put my finger because it's deep. It goes in, if I'm going to take a surveyor, maybe more than 8 millimeters depth of undercut. So that's deep undercut. This patient has that here, has it also here on the canine eminence area. It's extending to the maxilla up to the molars. Now, my question would be, if I have all of these undercuts in a position where I could withdraw the impression laterally rather than take it down. Yes, he has a severe undercut and it will be difficult to take the impression down after it solidifies. My question is, can I take it out? This is where the problem is with undercuts. Sometimes the impression, if it solidifies inside the patient's mouth, you cannot take the impression out even. When does this happen? We call it depending on the encirclement of the undercut.